We had a lot of high hopes for this guy in beta. Unfortunately, SG said, nope, average speed, this is what you get. Hey, thanks so much for checking out the channel. If you're curious about any other hero in Empires & Puzzles, you can view my website at anchorgame.com. There you will find I have graded every single hero with a calibrated team of graders. This resource will always be free. Thinking about supporting the hero grades and the breakdown videos? You're welcome to donate. Otherwise, feel free to share this resource with a friend. I have my exclusive line group called Anchor Cove, where you gain access to myself and tons of other experienced players with on-demand information and resources. If that piques your interest, all that information is on the opening page of my website with a short video. Let me dive into today's hero breakdown. Hey, thanks so much for checking out the channel. Today we're going to be doing a brand new hero breakdown on Sandbird. Sandbird Rock, coming to fly and splashing some sand into your eyes. It's not going to feel too good. He's got 762 on his attack, 739 on a defense, and 1361 on his health. Overall, statistically, that attack power, it's pretty ridiculous. At 762, I do like that a lot. Defensively, pretty good. Pretty solid. He is running at average speed. We had a lot of high hopes for this guy in beta. Unfortunately, SG said, nope, average speed, this is what you get. This video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. It is a free massive turn-based arc fantasy RPG. To try this game out, all you gotta do, go to the video description, click on the special links. You'll receive 100,000 silver and one free champion, Acolyte. This will only be available for the next 30 days and for new players. All your treasure, it's waiting for you right over here. He is part of the Sand Empire Heroes, which means that he does give you a bonus between 2 and 3 heroes. You get anywhere between 10% and 20% defense. All enemies receive 306 damage over 3 turns. All enemies get minus 50% decrease for any healing received for 2 turns. This effect can't be dispelled. Dispels status ailments from all allies. So, pretty cool hero that they initially released out to us. We had some pretty high hopes. Unfortunately, it fell a little bit not too good. It is pretty cool that all enemies are receiving damage over 3 turns. At average speed though, that's the unfortunate part. 306 damage over 3 turns, it's not going to really cut it. But it is kind of cool that he gives the defensive decrease for 2 turns. And then I think he is actually the first hero in Holy Class to dispel status ailments from all allies. So it's kind of some interesting stuff going on there. But overall, I'm not majorly stoked on everything. He is a barbarian class hero, which means that he is battling it out with the likes of potentially like Black Knight, or obviously you've got Gravemaker who is potentially taking them all. You also potentially have Cage Burrito that might be battling with it too. So some stiff competition there. Maybe you could use some emblems on him, but overall, maybe not so much. When we look at his Titan grade, he is going to get a B grade as far as his Titan grade goes. Reason being is it's 762. It's pretty awesome. I do like that attack power. It does attribute to a lot of different things. But unfortunately, the damage for over 3 turns and giving the healing isn't going to help out too much. You might maybe use him to dispel the status ailments from all allies so you don't have to bring antidotes. But other than that, I'm not really too stoked on there. Maybe a flex into B plus just because he has the ability to dispel all status ailments. But overall, probably not my first hero I'm bringing against a Titan. So he's going to get a B grade there. When we look at him offensively, he is going to get an A minus grade. There are a lot of enemies that are healing, so the decreased healing for 50% for 2 turns is definitely a factor there. He is dealing damage to all the heroes at for 3 turns, and he's also setting up so he's dispelling all ailments. So there is some possibility to be using him quite substantially. I don't really like that he is running at average speed, but I could see in this current meta when you've got Vilas, Talirias, and Gravemakers going around which are impacting all of your heroes. So setting him up so he does have the ability to dispel all status ailments, he is going to get an A minus grade there on offense. When we look at him defensively, he is going to get a B as far as the tank grade goes. He does have some decent defensive stats, but overall I'm not really too stoked. Giving the damage 306 isn't going to really help out too much. And then obviously you're probably not worried too much about getting the decreased healing because you can just smash him around a bit and not really worry about it. The dispelling the status ailments is not really going to factor too much as far as the tank grade goes. So he's going to get a B grade there.
When we look at his flank grade, he is going to get another B grade, maybe a B plus, but overall, I'm not really too stoked on him. With him running at average speed, it's not going to impact the board. The 306 damage over the three turns, I just think that there's a lot better heroes there, and you're not too crazy worried about the healing decrease. Overall, not too stoked. He's going to get a B grade. And then when we look at his win grade, it's just going to get worse from there. Being another C grade, I don't really like him on defense because now at this point with him running at average speed, hitting all the enemies, the decreased healing is not going to be too much. You're not really worried about the damage over the turns. I don't really like him at all on defense. He is going to get a B grade on defense. It is usable, but probably not my first choice. When we look at his weekly raid grade, he is going to get a B plus on rush attack. Having the ability to now run at very fast speed, you're decreasing the healing to where they don't really factor into things. I do like that he dispels the status ailment, so that is a factor there. The damage, it is pretty okay at very fast speed. I think that there might be a little bit better heroes, but still a solid hero on rush attack. He is going to get a B plus. Now he is going to get an A as far as his buff grade, being that he is pretty much the only hero in yellow that dispels any status ailments, running at average speed, making it so that they get damage. But what I like him for is going to be the decreased healing, because a lot of times in buff attack, you've got a lot of heroes that are going to be potentially healing. So he makes it so that that decreases. He is going to get an A on buff attack. When we look at his bloody battle grade, he is going to get a B plus grade there, just because he is dealing damage over time for three turns. He's making it so that he dispels any status ailments. Obviously, the healing isn't going to factor in too much, but still an okay hero. He is going to get a solid overall B plus grade. I think that this might flex maybe potentially into a B grade, but I think that he has a lot of usability on his offensive because he is dispelling all the status ailments. He's also giving them damage, and the decreased healing is definitely going to be a factor there. So potentially, if you are using him, I think that his strongest suit is going to be on offense. That's why he's going to get the B plus grade. In this current meta, he does have some usability. I wish that they didn't change him around too much from what the version was in beta, but unfortunately, this is what we get. So again, solid B plus grade. Thanks so much for watching this content. Please make sure you like, subscribe, turn those notifications on, and I'll see you on the next video.